Welcome to my channel. This is my first electric motorcycle conversion video. Bear with me, as I'm a complete novice when it comes to making videos. A few years ago, I picked up a Chinese Honda Ruckus knockoff, and I learned a lot about hub motors and their controllers while maintaining and upgrading it. I was frustrated with our local laws and the bureaucracy surrounding licensing and insuring electric scooters, and so I decided the only way to get around the issue was to convert an already road-legal 50cc scooter. I found a good deal on this 2005 Yamaha BWS 50, and I started the many months long conversion. Aside from removing the gasoline engine and supporting parts, the only major alteration was to install a rear swing arm. I got some expert advice that indicated that it was cheaper and safer to purchase a swing arm than to try to construct one myself. I found one that fit the bill on AliExpress for $160. It was high quality and made entirely from aluminum. It wasn't produced for the BWS, and so I had to modify the mounting points on the frame so that it would fit. My main skill set is electronics, and so I had to learn to weld in order to complete this task. I know that experienced welders will cringe at my results, but I did have it inspected, and all the structural points passed. Don't get me wrong, I'm not proud of these welds. They are obviously entry level. I do feel you can see me improving. And in the end, the crucial welds were of satisfactory strength. This 200-pound gorilla confidently rides the bike at 70 kilometers per hour every day. In addition to the swing arm mounts, I had to fabricate a second shock mounting point since the original version only had one. If any of you follow another YouTuber called A vs. E, you will recognize this following euphemism. A grinder in paint makes me the welder I ain't. With the swing arm mounted, it's time to figure out how I'm going to configure and mount the batteries. I decided I was going to mount the batteries low and retain the underseat storage. This was the most difficult task in this conversion. I got my batteries from a company on Alibaba that was selling 60 amp hour LG Chem lithium ion pouch cells. They were not cheap. I spent quite a lot of time trying to come up with a configuration that would fit. I finally settled on dividing the cells into two packs and mounting them as low in the frame as I could. I think there is an added benefit of a good weight and balance this way. The tabs on the pouch cells were made from copper and aluminum. I decided to go with aluminum strips that I used to sandwich this corresponding positive and negative tabs together for a 20 cells series configuration. This gives me a battery with 72 volts nominal and 60 amp hours. The BMS that I chose was from AliExpress and features Bluetooth connectivity that allows for an incredible amount of control and information to the user. I have tweaked the settings to allow me to only charge to 82 volts max instead of 84. I copied this trick from Tesla, and it is said to increase battery longevity. Mounting the batteries was no easy task. If I did my job right, I should not have to service these battery modules anytime soon. I mounted these modules in a Lexan case, as my intention was to get a good environmental seal. In retrospect, Lexan was unnecessary and I found it difficult to work with. Any future battery boxes that I make, I intend to be made from aluminum. Here you can see me installing the balance wiring. I made a Lexan case for the BMS. Even though it was protected by the cowling and the seat bucket, I wanted to give it a little bit of extra environmental protection. I decided to mount the Kelly motor speed controller in the frame above the rear tire. I added a strip of aluminum for the rear mounting point and screwed the front right into the frame. I realize I'll get a bit of galvanic corrosion as I have aluminum and steel in direct contact with each other. I was originally going to mount the 72 volts to 12 volts DC to DC converter here. But later on, I mounted it upside down underneath the motor speed controller. In the end, I didn't think the plastic fender was strong enough to hold it. I came up with an idea to use a thumb throttle for variable regenerative braking. I thought I was onto something, but then I later learned that others have been doing this as well. The best thing about this feature is that if you learn to use it correctly, you almost never have to use your brake pads, which in turn will extend the life of your brake pads way beyond their normal wear and tear cycles. Because of my modifications, I had to change the front cowling. Back in my car stereo days, I had learned to work with fiberglass resin and stretch cloth to make custom panels. I'm pretty rusty, so it took me about 3 tries before I got something that was serviceable. Making a functional panel is easy, but making it look really good is an art. Needless to say, I don't claim to be an artist in this regard. Here it is with all the panels back on. I used the boiled linseed oil and mineral spirits trick to refresh the plastic panels. Originally, I wanted to keep the analog gauges, but when I tried to convert the fuel gauge to voltage sensing, I messed it up. Luckily, I had a digital gauge sitting around that I was able to incorporate quite well. Well, I hope you liked the video. If you have any questions, just leave it in the comments section and I'll try and get back to you. My intention is to sell it. For me, it's all about the build.